Hello, Pythoneers. If you want to use the new DeepSeek R1 reasoning model in Python, then this video is for you. I show you how to get started and the code for a basic function for text response and stream output. Let's not waste any time and get straight into it. First, head over to DeepSeek.com. Here, we will find an overview of their offerings, such as the web and mobile chat apps, worth checking out. But for now, let's focus on the API platform, accessible from the top right corner. To use the API, you'll need to create an account. Once logged in, you'll land on the dashboard, where you can track usage and spending. The DeepSeek API isn't free, but it's impressively affordable. Pricing is significantly lower than the OpenAI O1 model, link here, while maintaining competitive performance on benchmarks. To use the API, we need to go to the top-up tab and add some money to our account. Here you can choose between different payment methods to recharge credit. In the left tab called API Key, we can now create our first API key like I do here. Press Create New API Key, and then enter a name and press Create API Key. Copy and cache it somewhere we need it soon. Before we get into coding here, a brief overview of the docs. Here we directly get the basic info about the API we require. DeepSeek is using the OpenAI SDKs to open the communication to their API. Here we get also the boilerplate code for Python, but we will add some changes to it. On the model tab, we get the info that we currently can access two models, the chat model and the reasoning model, which is the currently famous R1 model we will use for this video. Now let's head over to the code editor and start using it. Like I said, it uses the OpenAI SDK, therefore we start by importing the OpenAI library and some error handling classes. To install it, we run the command pip install OpenAI like I did here. Next, we can initialize the client by using the OpenAI class, where we pass first the API key 2, paste yours here now, and second the DeepSeek API URL, which is api.deepseek.com. Next, we can use the client to create a response using the chat.completions.create function. Here we pass first the model we want to use, as I do here for the DeepSeek reasoner model. Next, we can create the messages we want to send to the model through the API. Here, we could have different inputs, which is why it's a list, such as a system prompt, but for this tutorial, I'll stick to the basic user message function. Therefore, we use the role user and enter our input message after the content here. I use this time the question, explain quantum computing in simple terms. After this, we can add other optional values like temperature, which decides how I would say creative the model response and the max tokens that can be used to limit the costs. If your response gets cut off, increase this limit. This is the basic output version. I will show you the stream output after. To visualize the response, we simply print it to the terminal. Therefore, we access the response.choice at index 0 to get the full response from the model. This gives us also a lot of information about the input. If you just want to access the text response, we debunk the response more by adding .message.content to it. As you now see, we get back the pure text response from the model. If you're interested, you can see a short description now on how the model would explain quantum computing in simple terms. If you watched until here and you like it so far, please consider giving it a like and subscribe. As you may have seen, we got the entire response in one rush while it took long to answer. To improve this, we can use the stream function to improve the feedback to the user. But before we get over to the stream version, let's add some error handling to the code to see why it failed if it fails. Therefore, I wrap everything into a try block and add tree error handlers to it. First, the authentication error if there is anything wrong with your API key. Second, the API error if there is any error related to the API itself, like it's down or something like this. And third, an exception to catch all the other errors. This helps a lot in debugging whenever you get errors while using the API, and is in my eyes always worth it. Let me know in the comments if you are excited about the DeepSeek R1 model, because we got more OpenAI and Claude competition due to open source. Okay, let's go on. With just a few changes, we make it happen that the response will be shown in chunks, and if we get away earlier the first feedback of the model because it already outputs a response while still generating it. Therefore, we replace the response with a for loop that iterates over the chunks in the stream, we'll rename response 2, and say if chunk do, choice at index 0.delta.content contains some content, and if so, we print it immediately. The end parameter keeps the output on the same line, and flush true ensures real-time printing. Then we rename the response to stream and add the stream equals true parameter into the input. And that's it, we are ready to test it out. When we now run this, we see the response get printed in blocks or so-called chunks, which is a way better way for the user to get a response. I did a lot of testing on the OpenAI O1 model, and now, as I see the DeepSeek R1, I am very impressed. Let us know in the comment what you do think about it. I use it daily now on the web UI. If you want to use the API like a chat with follow-up question, then I have good news for you. I am already working on a video on this. Here is a short preview of the code if you can't wait, else stay tuned. Before we end the video, I want to show you how cheap this model is. Under the Usage tab, you see all the requests I did for the video did cost me like 1 cent. If you have seen my O1 video, you know that's very cheap. A single response here was about 18 cents, while I have here multiple for under a cent. This is wild, and a big improvement for accessibility of AI. And that's it. This is all I wanted to show you in this video. I hope this video helps you. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like and subscribe. On the left is first a video YouTube thinks you should watch, and then my latest one I suggest to you. Happy coding! I'll see you in the next one.